afternoon, South Africa. Welcome to Afternoon Express. It's a Tuesday, so you know what that means. It's cook-along day. Yay. How are you?
I'm good. Good to be in the kitchen, as always.
Absolutely. It's lovely to be back. And also, we've got special guests for you today who are going to help you cook.
I know. I'm very, very excited. Bringing some men in the kitchen. Oh. Are they going to just say, I love your hairstyle?
Oh, thank you.
It's so cool.
You hodo. And I know you're putting a twist to an old classic. I know anytime we're doing a classic, Clem has a twist to it, right?
So this one's a very mild twist, but it elevates the dish a lot. We're taking on the classic Italian lasagna, but we're going to do a nice little gremolata, which Sue's going to make for us, and that's going to elevate this dish so much. It's going to be delicious.
I know you've told me 1,000 times what a gremolata is, but I always forget.
What is it? So it's very simple. It's parsley, lemon, and garlic chopped up together. And then chucked over a dish. Lemon juice, sorry. But today we're gonna go with lemon zest, lemon juice, parsley. I'm giving it all away. Why am I giving it all away? I'm not gonna tell you what I'm doing. I'll tell you later.
My bad. So to get today's recipe and shopping list sent directly to your phone, simply SMS the keyword eat to 33650. SMSs are charged at 1.50 each and no free SMSs apply. But make sure you keep your device handy if you're following along and cooking along in the kitchen. It's an easy one today because we are streaming live on our YouTube page right now, and it's really great quality. Our lines are also open on 021-430-9881. I know you all want to speak to the Distruction Boyz, and if you have any culinary questions or if you get stuck along the way, you can always touch base with us on our social media platforms and share the best memory you have when you heard Omunye by Distruction Boyz. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. Later on in the show, we're also making something that will remind you of a mother's warm kitchen on a sunny afternoon. Their soft, light, and fluffy texture makes them hard to resist. I'm talking about cheese scones. Who doesn't love a good scone?
Love. I know it's more of a wintry thing, but to be honest, like a scone in the morning.
No, tea cools you down and scones go with tea.
There we go.
Absolutely.
Perfect.
Cool. And you know what to do. If you want the recipe for this fusion treat, then simply SMS the keyword clover then to 33650. And remember that SMSs are 1.50. No free SMSs apply. As we ushered in the year 2018, it was clear that Omunye was the anthem at every party. Sipho Mthembu and Quinton Gobozi were responsible for producing the biggest hit of the year. Hailing from Gwamashu in KZN, they've been crowned as one of South Africa's biggest GOM duo, and they have only just begun. Loft. That's one of my favorite music videos. And also, I feel like all your videos feel like there was a big party, like long before the video was shot, and the party carried on long after the video was shot. What is it like typically on a set when you guys are making a music video?
It's always crazy, eh? I mean, that's even how our songs come about, from good vibes, good times with friends and family. That's Durban for you.
Yeah. Yes.
So it's always crazy, man. Exciting. Yeah.
How would you define GOM culture?
I can't really put, you know, a definition on it. It's forever changing, you know.
Yeah.
It's edgy, it's funky, it's trendy. All those words combined and make GOM.
Yeah. I mean, you guys are doing exceptionally well. And I feel like GOM reminds me of the time when Kwaito was born, and it completely just revolutionized the scene, pop culture, how people express themselves. Where do you see it going?
The stars, stars, man. Starts it off with Gwamashu, and look at us now. You know, it's So anything's possible.
Yeah.
You're
both DJs and producers. Okay, tell me about your separate journeys as DJs and producers before you even met. Tell me how you got into it all.
I can say, like, for production. We met for production, eh? Yeah. Thing is, we started everything at the same time.
At the same time?
Yeah. It's been calm ever since, you know, so there was nothing different. We've always been doing the same thing together for a very long time, because before we were even born, our parents were friends. So
it was a family
thing. We grew up together, and like our moms are friends.
It's kind of like an arranged marriage type of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that. But an arranged marriage that works.
Yeah, I mean, it worked not just for us, but for the whole Clem community. I mean, because after Wololo came out, you know, a lot of people started getting jobs, started getting features as well, started getting radio play, TV coverage, news and stuff like that. So what we're doing, we're not just doing for us.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, Omunye is huge. It's huge. And there's no one who listens to that song and doesn't fall in love with it immediately. But there's been lots of interpretations around what it actually means. And some of them are a bit dicey. But what does it mean? What's the meaning of the song?
It's meant
to, or is it, do you
party,
want it to be left?
Packed.
The body is packed.
Yeah, so like everyone.
Body on body on body.
You can't even dance.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's like that, man. The music video depicts everything. It's a packed party. People are on top of people's bags. Everyone's having fun.
Yeah. I actually can't help but remember there was this drama around the release of the video with yourselves and Kanye Mbao. Do you want to just share a little bit of all that drama that went down?
Hey, well, she was crying about the complexion of her skin. Hey.
Why?
It wasn't as light as it was supposed to be, you know. I don't know. Maybe we gave her a 10 or something in the video. I don't know. It's crazy. But everything pulled out okay, and we all have fun. So that's what matters.
It definitely looks like everybody had fun. I mean, you guys are doing exceptionally well. You've got an album that's gone platinum and a triple platinum single. Yeah. You're traveling overseas and performing all over the world. How have people over the world received Clem and your music in particular?
They're still in awe, eh? Whenever we perform, their jaws drop, you know?
Yeah.
Because what we do is authentically South African. You can't find it anywhere in the world. So us doing it and doing it so well, and the sound being so clean, we've been well received all over the world. I mean, wherever we go, it doesn't matter. Your UKs, your Spains, wherever we go, people are loving the sound because of its authenticity and the drums, everything. It's African, so
it
African.
It feels distinctly, you know? African. Yeah.
So they're like, hey, what's going on? Yeah.
Yeah.
And but we just keep going inside and keep going inside.
Absolutely. Now you have a record label, and you obviously have a lot of people wanting to collaborate with you.
Yeah.
And how do you select who you work with?
I can say, like, we work with everyone.
Yeah.
Every producer, even underground producer, we still, like, do features with them. Because we still want to push, we still want to see them to go on top, like us, as Distruction Boyz. So I don't want to say we choose people.
Yeah.
Like, producers. We collaborate with everyone. Everyone is...
Yeah.
It's cool. Yeah.
That means you guys are always working, though. Sorry to interrupt you.
No, it's cool. We're forever working. I mean... it's those underground producers that actually got us to where we are right now. So we're just trying to lift them to be at our level as well. There's a lot of people doing Clem. It's not just us, but we're at the forefront. So we got to pave the way for them as well. Just like I said earlier on, it's a lot of people started getting jobs and bookings and stuff like that. So what we do for the sound system and not just for Distruction Boyz. So before becomes recognized as your hip-hops and your R&Bs, we're not going to stop. We're just going to keep pushing and pushing and pushing until maybe one day we have our own Clem Awards, you know?
Yeah.
Like your hip-hop awards.
Absolutely.
And stuff like that. So we're determined, man, and we're not going to stop.
Yeah, I mean, you guys are really young to have the success that you've gotten. How do you keep yourselves grounded? Because, I mean, it looks like a crazy world. It looks like you're always working, always partying, as if, like, there's no limits. You look at it and you feel like, wow, this world is limitless. Mm-hmm. But how do you keep yourselves grounded and keep your feet on the ground?
It's the communication.
Respect. Communication, respecting ourselves. Yeah, like, we're still respecting our parents.
Your parents,
so, like,
Have your parents ever asked you, why am I Distruction Boyz?
Because they
know. I feel like parents would always ask that.
Yeah. They know. I mean, they were there in the beginning, so they know everything. I mean, at first, it wasn't easy for them to come to terms with us being the people that we are, going out at night, coming back with no money from the performance and stuff like that, because that's how everything starts. You know, you start slow.
And I think that time we were too young.
To go
to the clubs and some stuff.
Yeah.
And we still have to go to school tomorrow.
Yes, and then there was school.
Yeah. Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, I really thought I wasn't going to make it through matric. I'm not going to lie. I was shaking. But then the paper came out, a few distinctions as well. So it was crazy.
Look at you. Nice. I know what it was like to work while being at school, because I started working early as well. Uh-huh. When I was 13. So it's a hard thing to pull off, but well done.
Thank you. You're
going to cook in the kitchen with us, and we're going to put all your cooking skills to the test.
Okay, wait, one more thing. We have a little present for you. It's an album that just went platinum. It's signed.
Thank you so much. Yes. My favorite thing to do when famous people give me gifts is to show my sons. I get home and I go, look what I got.
That's crazy, man.
Thank you so much. I want to show
you. I hope they can dance.
They can. Ta-da! To Bonnie, stay fly. Oh, you guys.
The whole time.
Making me shy. Now, they might be great at producing hits, but can they produce good food? Well, after the break, we put Distruction Boyz in the kitchen as we prepare the ultimate cheesy lasagna.
Clover fresh milk is way better. Made with love by Clover.
Molkazan is a natural Swiss-made product which supports better digestive health. Do you struggle with digestive or tummy problems, like cramping, bloating, and constipation? We're looking for three ladies from Cape Town, aged 30 to 50, who suffer from these problems, or from mild IBS, to take on a simple 21-day digestive health challenge that we will follow on Afternoon Express. Email your story to molkazanchallenge@cardova.tv to apply.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. We've put the Distruction Boyz in the kitchen. They're about to destroy this place, I'm sure. So everyone loves a good cheesy lasagna, and today's lasagna is the ultimate cheesy experience that we feel would be perfect for entertaining your dinner guests. And the best part is that it's budget-friendly because Clem has been shopping from the Woolies Daily Difference catalogue. Tell us a little bit about that.
And it makes a huge difference. So I've been shopping for the Daily Difference, like you said. So it's a catalogue you can physically get in your Woolies store. It's packed full of the deals. It normally runs for about 2 weeks.
Yeah.
If you're not going to get it in-store, check it out online. There's actually a tab on the Woolies website that says Daily Difference. All the deals are on there. So what I got today were my tinned tomatoes, my cheese, and my protein, which is the mince, which is, I got my kg of mince, and I got that from Daily Difference. Another thing is we're going to cook a big dish,
yeah,
and you can freeze it.
You can freeze it.
So, like, we know that it's summer right now. It is hot in K-Town,
yeah,
right?
Blazing hot.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
But we're gonna make this lasagna. You can still be enjoying a lasagna for dinner. Also, lasagna should never be served piping hot, by the way, which is great.
How come?
Yeah.
For me, though, I mustn't say this. I don't think any of your meat dishes should be piping hot. For me, you don't get to experience the flavors, the textures of the dish changes.
Going...
So you also want it to set, and that's got quite a bit to do with the temperature.
There we go. That's very, very important. Let's get cracking. I know you actually, you're good in the kitchen, apparently.
I'm joking.
You were joking. I was about to hand you the knife. I was going to take off for the day. Okay, but let's do the, by the end of the day, you will be good in the kitchen. So we're going to start on essentially the bolognese element of our lasagna, which is the meaty bit. Sue's going to handle the gremolata, but let's get to the meat going first.
Yeah, cracking.
So super easy. You like burgers, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, do you guys eat a lot of junk food? Because you're on the road a lot, eh?
Yeah.
Sure.
I mean, it's always available, sir.
Whatever's available?
Fast food, eh?
All right, so when it comes to burgers and mince, the better quality mince, the better burger you're going to have. The same goes for your bolognese. The same goes for any stew you're going to use when you use mince. So always get good mince. Look for the coloration. If it's nice and pink, you're winning.
Okay.
All right, so that's the trick.
If it's like dark or something?
If it's like dark, you know, the thing is, don't be put off too much if it's lightly, like a lighter... Like brown color, that's fine. It's beef anyway, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But when it starts looking like shades of green and yellow, walk away.
Or blue.
Walk away. Okay, so another thing is, essentially mince comes from a steak, right? They grind it up. So when you cook it, treat it like a steak. Put it in the pan, turn your heat up, and forget about
it. And leave it alone.
Yeah. Forget about it. I can see you were itching. You wanted to grab something. Yeah. We're going to let it cook for a bit. Sue's on the gremolata.
Yeah.
Talk us through the gremolata, please.
So gremolata, essentially and traditionally three ingredients, parsley, garlic, lemon zest. We're going to do the lemon juice as well. We're going to add some parmesan. Also, sometimes a lot of the Italians would add anchovies as well for that salt. But what this does, the acid, those pungent garlic flavors just really lift the rest of the dish, but also add a bite that balances out meat. So you've got this, you know, we're talking about the fact that we are all cooking today, literally in the kitchen and outside. This bite of freshness really just balances out this rich, creamy, cheesy dish. So this for me is just, Clem, I'm loving what you're doing today because this guy's on point. He's on point.
Yeah, I'm trying.
You guys have obviously also traveled a lot.
Yeah.
Which destination did you find had the best food for you?
South Africa has the best food, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah?
This one time we were in Germany and this soup was smelling so amazing. And then when I tasted it, it was...
Couldn't even finish it.
I couldn't. I almost ran away without paying the bill, that's how bad it was. But then I paid for it, so it's crazy. But South Africa has the best food by far out of all the places I've been to.
That's
amazing.
Do you eat mahogany? Do you traditional food?
Tina simbiza honey. All those kind of things.
Yeah.
I'm all for tradition as well. So,
yeah, I love that stuff.
But even Namibia, huh?
The food is nice, yeah.
The Namibian food is nice.
So guys out there, if you have any questions for the Distruction Boyz, I know you do, or you just want to congratulate them or just share your love for them, please call us on 0221 430 9881. I just remembered it. That is the answer.
I was like, Clem. I've got a question though. What won't you guys eat? Is something you won't go near? Don't say lasagna. It's too late.
No,
it's too late.
Yeah. Snails, man.
You don't like snails?
You like snails, dog. Have you tasted them?
Cool. I don't even want to taste them. I'm cool. Like.
That means you probably won't like oysters either.
I'm good.
No oysters for you.
All right, I think we're good now. You can kind of break it up a little bit in the pan. What you're looking for essentially is a little bit of like a brown crust on the bottom.
Yeah.
A little bit of that.
Look at that.
There we go. That's the thing. So what happens is if you end up moving it too soon, you break the fibers within the mince, and you'll see a lot of water coming out of the mince. That's not just water, that's flavor. So you don't want to do that. So you want to give it time to form that crust, and then you can start moving around in the pan.
The future is here, guys.
You are doing this. You are doing this. Okay, cool. So now what I need to do is salt and pepper. You can do your thing. Go crazy.
Salt and pepper.
Yeah. And then, how are you doing with the gremolata?
I'm doing good. So lemon taste going and starting to smell amazing. And that salt from the parmesan is really kind of also such a good part of this. You know, we've got such simple ingredients that really elevate any dish. Clean. And try it with steak at home. You know, if you're making a quick steak, adding this just really does elevate it to,
really
to a new
want
dish.
To stop making this thing because it just, you guys swear by it.
It's so good. You were saying to Clem earlier that he always talks about it.
Yeah.
We love the stuff.
Yeah.
And you have to make it fresh.
You've got
if
it,
if you don't make it fresh, your leaves end up bruising. They go brown. You lose the flavor. It has to be made fresh before you pop it in a dish. So you put some stuff in the pan, but do you know what you put in the pan?
I trust you.
Oh, no. Okay, so we added some bay leaves, we added some garlic, some rosemary, and some thyme. So those are aromatics. So now that's going to get in that mince before we add the next ingredient, which is my secret to any stew and to any dish like a lasagna. It takes long. So if you want to bump up that umami flavor, we'll talk about umami. This is the original umami bomb.
Umami.
Worcester sauce.
Worcester sauce, of course.
I mean,
of course.
Even vegetarians love it.
Sour, salty, a little bit of sugar.
The garlic is doing the thing, eh?
Cool. It's looking good. It's smelling great. And we finish up our main meal after the break. And remember, you can call us live on 021-430-9881 if you have any questions for Distruction Boyz. We'll be right back.
This coming Thursday on Winner Home, with two double challenges under their belts, the design duos are briefed on their next room.
The master.
Will they be masters of design, or will they get caught napping?
Oh, but I'm not too sure what's going on in here. I'm hoping that they're getting things done.
Watch all the drama unfold as Team RNK, Team Contrast Control, and the Perma Peeps battle it out for the title. Live at 7:30 p.m. on SABC3. The stage is yours. Winner Home, proudly brought to you by Capitec and Private Property, with Samsung products designed for your connected lifestyle. Grand Prize Luxury Penthouse Apartment by Bowen Properties. This is your chance to win the home you've always dreamed of. Enter the Winner Home competition by voting for your favorite design duo on privateproperty.co.za and stand a chance of winning a fully decorated apartment at Pardeflay Lifestyle Estate, developed by Baldwin Properties worth over 3 million rand. Plus, you'll automatically be entered into the weekly draw, where this coming Thursday night, you could walk away with a Samsung Galaxy Note 9 smartphone with Bluetooth remote S Pen, AI camera, PC-like performance, and built-in decks with carbon sheet cooling. And if that's not enough, Capitec clients stand a chance to win a further 5,000 Rand in cash. Competition details plus T's and C's can be found on the Private Property website. Winner Home, every Thursday evening at 7:30 on SABC 3. The stage is yours.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Flavors are sizzling in the kitchen and it just smells incredible. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. I'm having gulps and gulps of this. I hope you guys are ready to eat up to this.
Yeah,
so we do have a caller on the line, Londega from Pietermaritzburg. How are you?
Well, thanks. How are you?
Good, thank you. Take it away.
Okay. I want to ask the Distruction Boyz, if they had an opportunity to feature an international artist, who would it be?
Great question. Who would it be?
That's a tough one, eh? Yeah. It's very tough. Diplo, eh? Diplo.
Diplo!
I was thinking, yeah. But why, though?
He gave us an opportunity when no one else would.
You know? Sona.
Really?
Yeah, we went to Sona Festival with him Barcelona. In Barcelona, in Spain. We played, Black Coffee played, and he played after Black Coffee. So it was a crazy, crazy setup. And I'll always be grateful to him for that.
That's amazing.
And he even came to South Africa just to see our performance.
Really?
Yeah, so it was crazy.
He's such an open-minded artist.
Is there something in the pipeline already? The way you guys are like,
we don't want to give away too much, you know?
Big stuff you keep under wraps. You just keep it under wraps. But I just love him because he's such an open-minded artist. Yeah. And he's just, he loves this country.
You know?
Yeah.
And cool. Like he was doing a tour, I think, last week.
Yeah, just a month back.
Africa
tour.
Was here and other African states as well.
And one of his latest music videos was actually shot
in
Durban.
Yeah.
Taxiculture, the dancing,
featuring
the clothing, the one with Anne Marie, Live My Life. I mean, that was amazing.
With the rudimentals, right?
Yeah. It was beyond.
No, it's a dope track, yeah. But thank you so much for that question. That was a good one. So to get today's recipe and shopping list sent directly to your phone, simply SMS the keyword EAT to 33650. SMSs are 1 rand 50 each. As you know, no free SMSs apply. Our lines are still open on 021-430-9881. If you have any culinary questions, you want to know what's cooking in the kitchen, or you just want to chat to the Distruction Boyz, please do so. Don't hesitate. What's next, Clem?
All you, Sue.
Is it all me? So I'm going to start working on the cheese sauce. So, and as Clem said, we literally are doing this from scratch. So it's we're making your proper roux and we're going to start adding our cheese. Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask the mister to hand back my utensil, which is like, what are you doing with my
spoon? I'm waiting to eat.
Are you ready to eat?
And awesome. We have another caller on the line, Vanessa. Hi, Vanessa. Welcome. What's your question or comment?
Hi, I would like to tell the Distruction Boyz that I admire their music, especially the Pesgo Monye.
Oh, Monye, Pesgo Monye.
Oh, Monye. Thank you
so much, Vanessa. Do you know what my favorite thing is? To hear little kids sing that song. It's the cutest thing. It is so cute. So just take me through how you guys started. Like, if there's a kid out there who feels like they're talented, they love music so much, and they want to get started, and they just practically, what do they do? I mean, what do you do? Do you just get a computer? How do you do it?
You need to make memes what you have, you know. When we started, the things we used to use was a small PC, and would take his mom's speakers because his mom had a home theater system.
It's
still one speaker.
So you connect the speakers.
And then we'll just join the chords, man, and we made music from there.
Did you use an app? What would you use?
Yeah. We still use it now. It's called Fruity Loops. So we're still using it. Changed our lives, man.
How long ago was that?
It's 2012.
2012.
Yeah.
I love that because I love asking practical questions mm-hmm. about how to get started because somebody's sitting somewhere and going, I feel like I need a lot of money or I feel like I have to be rich already.
You know.
But you don't.
Someone's sitting on a billion and they're just not doing anything. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
There we go. Amazing, but we might not eat today, guys. Let's get the food going. Sue, how far are you?
So you've mixed flour and butter.
Flour and the butter. Yeah. You want that to cook for a couple of minutes because you don't want that floury taste when you have your sauce. So let that go for a couple of minutes. Keep working it loose. And this is the thing with a cheese or a white sauce base. We season every layer because it's quite hard to get it salty enough at the end. And then we're just slowly going to add our milk a little bit at a time. And then
don't you have to stir furiously so that you don't get lumps?
You've got to stir because you don't want lumps.
Do you want me to pour for you?
Please, darling, that'd be great. In the beginning, you're probably going to think it's going to stay lumpy, but it won't if you're vigorous enough, so it's going to take some elbow grease.
Yes.
And you'll just carry on adding until you've got the right consistency.
Perfect.
And once this is done, we'll start working in our cheese.
Do you have any duck tips if someone does end up with a lumpy sauce?
What are you
blender?
A blender.
Have you used a blender?
I get distracted in the kitchen. I start talking to people. It happens. You end up with a lumpy sauce. Chuck it in a blender.
Yeah.
I must say, I've never used a blender before. Watch me need one today.
No. I don't want to tell the viewers, but we actually had to make one before the time because I knew the Distruction Boyz were going to keep us busy in the kitchen.
Yeah.
We got one done. We got one done before the time already. But that's looking good.
And that's perfect.
Nice.
And then we'll just see. We'll let this flour absorb all of the liquid, and then we'll go until it's a nice consistency, and then we're going to add in a couple of mixes of cheese. So I've got Gouda, I've got cheddar, I've got mature cheddar. Just going to let this cook out and try not to get
distracted.
So
are you going
to
add all three cheeses?
I'm going to add all three cheeses, and we were saying we were talking about how hot Cape Town is. This meal is reminding me of childhood, but like this cheese is so soft that I kind of want to do like
squeeze it.
He's really hungry.
That's yours. You can have it.
I'll leave some for you. Okay, just hold cheese. But it's going to be a cheesy good dish.
Do you guys have any siblings?
Yeah, I have two baby sisters. So I'm the oldest.
Cute. And you? Yeah.
Two brothers and one sister.
And do they all look up to you?
And they admire.
Oh, that's adorable.
I'm just watching Bonnie do this.
Do you want me to carry? So I can use all this milk.
You're probably going to need all of the milk. Yep.
Can we eat or you guys?
Guys. It's almost time. It's almost time.
Okay.
I think this one's already done. So.
I find when you're making a sauce like this, it helps actually do like a figure of eight stirring thing.
Bonnie's TV show's coming out next year, guys.
Ready for that cooking show.
And guys, the balloon whisk really does help eliminate some of those lumps. If you really carried on beating that, you 9 out of 10 times are actually going to get the lumps out by just using.
Absolutely.
Just
doing all that our way. Lumps are gone. So this is how dinner should be done. To get the ingredients list and links sent to your phone, please SMS eat to 33650. And if you want to see how we put this dish together one more time, here's a recap. Whoever watches our cook-alongs knows that I'm very pedantic about lumps and I just absolutely love cooking, so I can't stop stirring the sauce. But after the break, we make the perfect cheese scones. Remember to hit us up on our socials and share the best memory you have when you heard Omunye by Distruction Boyz. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the hashtag Afternoon Express or just go to our Facebook page and leave us a comment.
Clover fresh milk is way better. Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, if you need any inspiring recipes for easy entertaining, look no further. On our cook-along today, we'll show you an easy, cheesy scone recipe that'll bring the tastiest of rewards. You do not want to miss out on this recipe. SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. SMSs are charged at 1.50 each, and no free SMSs apply. And a scone recipe is a classic. You always have to have one. I mean, if you don't know it off by heart, you just have to have one on standby.
And it's the easiest recipe as well. Yes. I've even added an extra ingredient today because essentially if you have butter, buttermilk and self-raising flour, that's a scone mixture. You add a bit of salt and pepper, salt just to like season it slightly, yeah. But that's the recipe. So in here I've got some cake flour.
And the trick with scones, though, is how do you get them soft every time? Soft and fluffy.
Okay, I'm going to go through, like, the steps I have to do that. Good. It's very, very simple, but it's also easy to get wrong. Okay.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
So, baking powder going in, sugar going in, and then we've got a little bit of salt. Just flake that in.
Is it true that you create more fluffiness in a scone or a cake if you use a sieve?
You can sieve the flour in. It does aerate the flour slightly, but that's not the trick. The trick is actually when you work with the scones. Uh-huh. Try not to work with it, well, as little as possible. That's the trick. Oh. And then you'll end up with a very tender, light, fluffy scone.
Okay.
So what's next? Butter. And also, I feel like you get a better result by using your hands.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can totally do this in a machine, but actually feeling the way that the butter crumbles through the flour by hand, like a machine can't do that. So the trick is now you're going to use your fingertips and you're kind of just like breaking the butter off into the flour, combining the two, but not actually breaking all the butter off that it disappears. You want to keep it nice and chunky. That's also the trick.
Really?
You want to see the butter in the flour. So you keep on doing that. Get it all nice and mixed out through. And then you ask your presenter to chuck in the cheese.
Okay, all of it?
All of it.
Okay.
I think today's keyword should have been cheese for everything.
Cheese for everything.
You can chuck
cheese
that all in.
Cheese is everything.
It really is. That's the one problem with me going dairy-free ever in life.
Oh, no.
Cheese. There we
That'll
go.
That'll be the end of you.
It's done. Okay. Buttermilk's going in. Buttermilk's also great because it reacts with the baking powder that we put in there. And that also gives a bit of that lift. So if you can pour that in.
Yeah,
that's a little drill glass over there.
Okay, just a reminder that the keyword for this recipe is clover. SMS that keyword to 33650 for the list of ingredients and your recipe.
Cool. Egg going in, and you give it a good mix. And now what you're going to do is you're going to use your spatula to mix it until it just forms a ball. And you're going to turn it out onto your working surface, and then just shape it with your hands. So I'm going to put this to the side because I've got one.
Okay.
And just like this. And once it comes into a ball, the trick is to not work with it too much.
Okay.
So now I'm going to be honest with you. Those ones are slightly overworked. Okay, that's fine. The trick, like I said, use a rolling pin, work it out nicely. Keep them nice and thick as well. But still a nice and tender scone on the inside.
Still a good scone.
No, it's so super tender.
Are they called scones?
You know what is it called? I call it a scone. What our viewers out there call it, I don't know.
Yeah, what do our viewers call them? Please let us know what you call them, scones or scones.
I'm guessing everyone's going to call it a scone. But in America, it's called a...
A biscuit.
A biscuit.
I know, right?
What? No. So
I know, it's called a biscuit.
It's 100% a scone.
But those American biscuits are something else.
Oh my goodness. And
they load
gravy
so
over
much
it?
Butter in there. They're just amazing.
Well
they're
done
amazing.
To them for that.
Yeah, they pulled that off.
So you see, I didn't do a lot of rolling. I just got my basic shape. Now here's my other trick, right? You can use a knife and cut it down. Not all scones have to be round, by the way.
Oh.
Go triangle, go crazy, go square. Mm-hmm. But traditionally, they would be round. So now you dip your little cutter into some flour to help it go through. Now, normally you would be like, you know, right? What I'm saying is do that, punch down.
Yeah, because you just don't want to keep working it so much.
Not just that only, but by you doing that, you're actually kind of twisting the strands within the dough. So instead of the scone rising up, it's now rising in this little wiggly shape that you've done.
Really?
Yeah.
Everyone does that. Everyone does that thing.
There we go. So straight down. That's all you need. Scone science, yo. There we go. Keep it nice and chilled. Pop that into the oven, 20 minutes. Also, a really great thing is that scone dough itself will keep in a freezer for months.
For months, yeah.
And it thaws out very quickly because there's butter and fat in there, and that thaws out very quickly.
Yeah.
So you're always kind of like half an hour away from a fresh scone.
Amazing.
Which I love.
Well, I've decided that today is my cheat day. I know I decided when I saw what you were making today, so I'm definitely going to go for one of these scones.
Go for
it. And I'll go for more of the other ones that you're making and the lasagna. These are perfect nibbles for when entertaining. And remember to SMS the keyword Clover to 33650 to get this recipe sent to your device. SMSs cost R1.50 each. And if you need to see how this was made one more time, watch this space.
Made with love by Clover.
Wow, I'm still chewing on those beautiful scones. There's nothing smoother than winning than when you buy Tropica with the Tropica Smooth Fan Competition. Stand a chance of winning incredible instant prizes. This week, Tropica lovers stand a chance of winning incredible prizes from Lewis, with Lewis having up to 36 months to pay, same-day delivery, and an optional extended two-year guarantee. Lewis will really welcome our Tropica Smooth fans home, and don't forget the grand prize of 250,000 Rand cash and a Honda Amaze Comfort CVT. The prize will be fitted with genuine Honda seat covers. All you have to do is buy a Tropica, follow the details on the pack, select your favorite celebrity, and stand a chance to win instant prizes, airtime, and so much more. T's and C's on tropica.co.za. Stay right there, because after the break, Distruction Boyz will be performing live in the loft.
Moving out? Need more room? Scaling down? Private property is a great place to start your search. With thousands of new properties from South Africa's top real estate agents, banks, developers, and homeowners. It's the easiest way to find your next home. Search for a home on any device, anytime, anywhere. Search privateproperty.co.za.
Enter the Win a Home competition on privateproperty.co.za and stand a chance to win a brand new, fully decorated apartment at Parterflay Lifestyle Estate, developed by Baldwin Properties, worth over 3 million rand.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. The moment we've all been waiting for is about to happen. But thanks to SofaCompany.com, our studio looks trendy, stylish, and comfortable. SofaCompany.com is proud and stands by the products they create and deliver to their customers. Customer service is their primary focus, and their spirit and business model are open, honest, and most definitely authentic. SofaCompany.com's stylish products are designed in Denmark and handcrafted by talented artisans in their factory in Vietnam. As a customer, this means that it'll be much easier for you to communicate directly with the producer, which ultimately makes for a more pleasant experience. Make sure you head to their website, sofacompany.com, for more information, or visit their Cape Town showroom at 115 Waterkant Street, or their Jersey showroom, Courtyard, 8 to 10 Desmond Street, Cramerville. Danish design delivered right to your doorstep. This dynamic duo is known to have pioneered the gom genre by consistently bringing a distinctive and electrifying energy on any song they produce. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Distruction Boyz.
Le boots about digger. The boots about food now. The boots about bigger. The boots about food now. The boots about boots, boots.
Come on over, guys. Nami Petu Mutanu Dingai. Well done.
Thank you.
Well done. Love that track. So I can't wait for the verdict. You have to taste and tell us.
It was all your hard work.
Going inside now. Oh, look at that. Oh.
So amazing, Clem. Yeah, I love it. I love how you kept it all together.
It was a team effort, and that's the thing. If you don't rest it, you don't get those layers, like, you know what I mean? You don't
see
it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what has to, you have to do.
I hate it when I make lasagna and it just slips and slides and just becomes a mess.
Bolognese.
What do you think?
Can we go on tour together?
Oh, you can be our private chef.
There we go. Dan, I'm leaving tomorrow, guys. I'm on tour with Distruction Boyz.
The whole time.
How easy was that? Bye-bye, Clem. It's been real. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place. Happy eating and God bless.
Ciao.
Express, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.